I know there's a lot of interest out there for Pool 3 exclusive decks and Pool 3 exclusive content. So I'm going to be doing a new series where we're going to be doing deck lists exclusive to Pool 3. I'm going to be playing the entire gamut of archetypes. We're going to be doing it on the ranked ladder, and we are pushing to infinite with these deck lists. Guys, these deck lists are successful, and I can't wait to share them with you. And most importantly, they're all Pool 3 exclusive. If you are interested in seeing more of this content, I kindly ask that you consider hitting the like button. Not only does it tell me that you like this content and that you want to see more Pool 3 exclusive content, but it also helps the YouTube algorithm like more than you could imagine. Like literally it doubles the views if you hit the like button, and essentially it tells everyone that, hey, we're interested in Pool 3 still. Don't just make Pool 4 and 5 card decks because, you know, not everyone has them and we want to see some interesting stuff. Now, we're starting with Hella Discard because I think there's a lot of interest in Hella right now. I will admit that I think that Hella is really frustrating to play at times. It's like a casino style deck. If you're looking to rank up, like right now I'm facing, you know, high kind of like 80s, 90s and infinite level players with a season reset. And what's happening is like I find the Hella list to be less consistent than say some of the other lists we're going to be featuring. But I know people want to talk discard, so here it is. Now the one thing I will say is that Invisible Woman is kind of mandatory here. I don't like saying that cards are mandatory, but Invisible Woman makes the deck list kind of function, because without Invisible Woman, anytime you have Hella in your hand, you're basically going to discard it. Like, it becomes extremely difficult to play around Hella. And in the gameplay examples, you'll see how I navigate using Invisible Woman, sometimes really creatively, even with like Giganto's Infinauts and hiding stuff behind it that they might not realize. You could hide Ebony Maw behind it, and the ongoing effect isn't in play, so you can basically play more cards into the location. There's a lot of clever things that you can do. Now, the key thing to understand here is that you really don't want to discard Hella. You obviously want to play Hella on turn 6, and what you do is you have a number of cards here that really play an important role in controlling the discards. First of all, you have Calling Wing. Calling Wing is guaranteed to hit the lowest cost card for a discard, which is often Ebony Maw. That's great. Moreover, it can be someone like Swordmaster if you weren't able to play Swordmaster early on because you weren't able to kind of dodge playing Hella or discarding Hella. The other option, of course, is Lady Sif. And Lady Sif is great because Lady Sif hits the highest cost card in your hand, which is going to be one of the sixes, hopefully not Hella. But most importantly, Death as a 9 is guaranteed to get hit by the Lady Sif. Another thing that I'll note here is that Black Cat is a high value card that just gets straight up discarded. It's for free. You don't have to worry about actually playing a discard card because Black Cat can get discarded naturally. Now, Hellcow is amazing because it discards two unique cards no matter what, and it's going to make sure that it kind of empties your hand. Naturally, what you usually want to do is have a lane with Invisible Woman, someone like Swordmaster, Hellcow, and then that last spot has to be Hella. Now, one thing I'm going to tell you, if you don't have Giganto and if you don't have Death, you could theoretically use like Hulk and other big cards. One thing I will say for sure is that while Vision's a good card, Captain Marvel is definitely the best. Now, if you don't have Captain Marvel, Vision's definitely a good sub in. But what I will say, I wouldn't even say that. I don't know if I would play Vision, honestly. Yes, you could. But realistically, Captain Marvel does an amazing thing for these lists. Usually, like, you would probably just want like I would actually put Arrow instead. Like, if you're not going to be playing Captain Marvel, instead of playing Vision, you could play Vision, but maybe Arrow is better just because of the disruption. Because the thing about Captain Marvel that's so important is that when you discard Captain Marvel and you bring Captain Marvel back, the key thing you have to understand about Hella is that the cards end up in random locations. When that happens, sometimes you put way too much power on one side. Like, if you put the Infinaut, like where the Infinaut lands is kind of important. It's 20 power. And what Captain Marvel does is it reduces that RNG a little bit, and it makes sure that it'll fly to where you have the greatest chance of winning. But overall, I do think Hella Discard is a fun decklist to play. I do think that it is a little more high rolly, can be a little frustrating. Like, if you discard Hella, you get pissed off. If you don't draw Hella by turn 6, you get pissed off. And snapping can feel awkward because, like, you don't quite know if they're ever going to just Cosmo Invisible Woman, right? So snapping and then like being like, there's no way they have Cosmo, and then they slide out of Cosmo under Invisible Woman and you feel big sad, that can feel pretty rough as well. So navigating this deck list does take practice. I do think it's one that like you can rank up with, but the consistency might leave a little more than you know, what is desired. Anyways, guys, that's the list. If you'd like to join us on Twitch TV, definitely click the link in the description and in the comment section below. We have a ton of fun and I'd love to see you there. Now enjoy these amazing highlights that are recorded live that illustrate how the deck list is played. Does 3 costs have the best overall grouping of cards? I don't know, Nightbeat. I think that 3 costs have a lot of really impactful cards. Like, they're continuously incredibly impressive. But I wouldn't say that they're like OP or anything along those lines. But I definitely do think that three-cost cards are fantastic. Okay, now we have Hela. We do this. We don't quite have enough discard here, but if we have to skip next turn, we can play Infinite. We've already discarded two. Shang-Chi, what? Buddy. That's wild. Just casually throwing out Shang-Chi? That's wild! Damn, I might actually skip this turn. Skipping this turn for a guaranteed Infinite play might actually be nice. He already played Shang-Chi. I think we skip this turn. The only problem is we can't control the Hela discard, so we have to be careful. We really want Hellcow drawn or Calling Wing. What the hell? Nice. Do I play Infinite mid? If I play Infinite mid, I could Swordmaster Calling Wing. And he won't realize this is Infinite, and we basically guarantee the win mid. Gamer plays Magic, okay. I don't know what the hell deck this guy's playing, but God bless him. Bless his heart. I can actually just play Giganto here. Calling Wing? Swordmaster Hela. He thinks this is like Hellcow. He doesn't realize it's Infinite, right? So we're kind of using Invisible Woman to really good effectiveness. There's going to be an Infinite dropping on top of an already laid down Shang-Chi. It's Magneto. Okay. Pretty cool. But we're not doing what you think we are, dude. That's an Infinite and Calling Wing. I mean, the Calling Wing, whatever. We're going to 8. Always risky, of course, but like, he's not going to think that we're going to win mid. We set up power here. We set up power here. I think we get him for 8 cubes here. I don't see how he wins. And if he Cosmos here, he's going to get outpaced by this Infinite. We lose the discard on Calling Wing, unfortunately. But I think we're going to be okay. We want to hit the Captain Marvel here. So we are going to be winning mid without him realizing it. Because that is an Infinite. And this is where Invisible Woman can be really interesting. Like, when you don't play her like people would expect. Oh, it's Captain Marvel too. That's so beautiful. Oh my god, look at this. Okay, that's your turn 6 play. Oh my god. He has no idea. No idea whatsoever. That is an absolute train wreck. 3 lanes, 8 cubes, baby. Let's go. That game was so clean. So clean. See ya, Black Cat. Miniaturized Lab, eh? Gotta play the Invisible Woman. Could play Invisible Woman on Kamar-Taj, but honestly, if we don't have Hela, Kamar-Taj is perfect because we can just blow up the hand and only use the Invisible Woman when we really need to. Oh, sad. Okay, that works for us, I guess. Lol. Baxter building. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Okay. So we've got Hela. We've got Hela here. What we probably do is Swordmaster into Baxter. Now we play Lady Sif. Oh my god, I made a mistake. Let it be known, I made a mistake here. I thought that was Death, not Infinite. So, GG's. Oh, lucky. Okay. So I thought, let it be known, what I just did was stupid. I thought that that was Infinite. Not Infinite. I thought it was Death. My god, I just got confused. This is what lack of sleep does. This is what sleep deprivation does to a man. So what I just did was bad. Do not do that. I just got really lucky. Really lucky. Let's be clear about that. Horrible play. Absolutely horrible play. I'm so tired, guys. I don't sleep. Oh my god. That was almost an absolute train wreck. But it's funny. I like it. Okay, we got the Ebony Maw. No, we don't skip. Obviously, we don't skip. So he just snapped. We play Hella Invisible Woman, and then we can play whatever we draw next and discard Ebony Maw. He's snapping because he has Cosmo. It's Enchantress. Doesn't matter. We still get our cards. Enchantress is not the cleanest counter at this point in the game. Because we still get to actually do this. Right? Cosmo's a better counter. And we get Giganto. This game's easy. Shang-Chi would be spicy, but like, he would just Shang-Chi mid. And probably not have enough to gap that side there. So again, really good play there. Cosmo's a better counter to Invisible Woman than Hella is. If he was holding Enchantress, he should have played Enchantress on turn 5 before Hella was there. Because it would have discarded the Hella, right? Well, had a chance to, at least. He's going. Shang-Chi's mid, exactly what I expected. He's up by 1 there. Killmongers, no way. Let's go, gamers! That's 8 cubes, baby! Let's go! Never, ever doubt Captain Marvel in discard decks. Never doubt it. How many times have I said in my videos that Captain Marvel is actually the best discard card in Marvel Snap? Sunspot. Damn, Sunspot's always good. Love me Sunspot. Black Cat's gone. Nice. Good on you, bud. Now, in this case here, we got a gamble roll of the Swordmaster. It is what it is. Okay, we do have Invisible Woman. I think we gamble play Swordmaster. If he snaps, we don't. But I think we need to put power here for a sec. This is a 66% chance we hit proper. Okay, good. Okay. I was okay with that gamble. I didn't love it, but I felt like we had to get on the board in that location. Okay. This is unfortunate. We do this. Of course, She-Hulk. Disaster. It's okay. Whatever we pull next, we don't have to play onto Elysium. We needed to pull a discard card, actually. We get the +1. Possible win here. Darkhawk. Darkhawk. Mystique. Okay, a lot of value on board. Okay. We actually got completely lucked out. On to this Captain Marvel, baby. Higher, further, faster. How many videos am I going to make where, like, for a second you think you're going to lose, and then Captain Marvel just wins? All right, what we can actually do here is we can probably hold the Ebony Maw for a sec. It's always friggin' Scorpion. It's always Scorpion. That's frustrating. Okay, weird flex. We We got Hela, which means we have to play like this. Interesting decision of Cosmo over there. He also can't play into Altar of Death, mind you, eh? This guy misplayed this game completely. He wins Bar Sinister, but he can't access Altar of Death, and he's only up by two on the left side. So this guy has made mistakes. The piloting of this deck has been pretty rough. We have the setup right now with Invisible Woman, Hellcow, Hela. This is a pretty clean win. Uh-oh. That's bad. Oh, 50-50, 50-50. That, my friends, sometimes lucky. Sometimes you get a little lucky, you know? Because Swordmaster is going to hit this death. This is the cleanest win. That was actually awesome. This guy made so many mistakes. Swordmaster was going to hit death. Hela was going to proc. It was beautiful. Beautiful win. This would have been so good.